gatto, mister robatto. Dopodomani gatto, mister robatto, manda animale. Dopodomani gatto, mister robatto, mi inizio un'ocività.
Oh, hi, kids. I didn't even see you come in there. My name is Aaron. I am an electrical engineer, and I'm working here at NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center. So welcome to the center. Now, I heard you guys are really interested in robots. Well, you know what? You have come to the absolute right place, because I, too, am really interested and excited about all the cool robots that are out there. And I just so happen to know a colleague of mine right over here who is also really interested. Why don't I introduce him to you right here?
Oh, hello.
How are you?
Good to see you. I'm well.
Good. Excellent. Well, I have a group of kids here that in robots.
Well, absolutely. Welcome, kids. I'm Grant. I also am in electrical engineering, and you came to the right place. As Aaron stated earlier, you came to the right place if you're interested in robots. Well, Aaron, by the way, what sort of robots are these kids interested in?
You know what, Grant? That's a good question, because there's lots of different kinds of robots. So, I don't know, what do you think about when you hear the word robot?
Well, you know, first time I hear robot, I think of the sort of type of robot that resemble people, you know?
Oh, you know, that's what a lot of people think of, because there's lots of movies out there, popular culture, depicting robots like that. I just so happen to know a robot made by the company Honda.
Yes, Asimo.
Asimo, that's right. I'm glad you've seen this robot.
I have, it's amazing.
Well, you know what, I think these kids need to see what Asimo is like.
Let's show them.
Let's show them right now.
Let's do it.
Standing 4 feet, 3 inches tall, and weighing 114 pounds, Asimo is a robot that resembles a small astronaut wearing a backpack. He can walk or run on 2 feet and can run up to 4.5 miles per hour. You may be wondering where Asimo gets his strange name from. His name actually is short for Advanced Step in Innovative Mobility. As you can see, Asimo can do all sorts of neat things, such as climb upstairs or recognize people's faces. He can even access the internet wirelessly, so it can tell you the weather, the news, or when a movie is playing at the local theater. And he is not alone. He has many brothers and sisters. As of February 2009, there are over 100 Asimo units in existence. Each one cost just under $1 million to create. His backpack is actually his food source. It is a big battery that can last up to an hour before it has to be recharged.
Technology. Making better, better. Onwards, upwards, any way but backwards. Tapping progress on the shoulder and saying, more forwards, please.
Wow, you know, wasn't that Asimo robot so cool?
Man, I love Asimo. It's so neat. He can do so much, you know?
You're so right. And I kind of wish I had one right in my own home.
That would be amazing.
That would be. You know, it's funny because there's so many different kinds of robots. I mean, I'm looking at the floor here. The carpet is kind of dirty. And that reminds me of the one robot called Roomba.
Roomba, yes. I've heard of it.
Yes, why don't you explain that to the kids?
Well, hey, kids. Yes, the Roomba, it's a self-cleaning robot that goes around searching and cleaning the carpet.
Yeah, it's really cool. In fact, we need to show these kids this.
That's
this
a good robot. Idea.
Why don't we see if we can get a video of it?
Let me see if I can do that. One moment. Yes, hello? Yes, could you please play the Roomba video? I'll be right up.
All right, let's watch, kids.
Roomba is an autonomous robotic vacuum cleaner made by the company iRobot. It is over a foot in diameter and sits just a few inches high, so it's really not that big. It can be programmed to crawl around and vacuum your floor in a set amount of time and can avoid obstacles while it's doing this. A large contact sensing bumper is on the front half of the robot, while another sensor at the top allows it to see what's in its path. When it's done vacuuming, it will return to its home, which is a power station that recharges the robot. This way, it will be ready to vacuum the floor the next time it gets dirty.
Enjoyed the short clip of the Roomba. Isn't it neat how robots are being designed today to do jobs that we used to have to do?
You know, Grant, that is pretty truly amazing. I mean, just think 20 years ago, if you told anybody that there was a little robot that would go around and automatically clean your floor for you, would you believe it?
No, I would not.
I wouldn't either. That's pretty incredible.
It would be.
In fact, what do you think robots will be doing in the future, you know?
You know, that's a great question. I was thinking, wouldn't it be neat if there was a robot that could carry heavy loads for us? And so, for instance, when going to school, I wouldn't have to carry my backpack.
You know, that would be really cool. In fact, I think I've heard of a company that does that. Boston Dynamics?
Oh, yes, I know a little bit about that. Okay. They have Big Dog. Have you heard of it?
I haven't heard of it.
Well, Big Dog is really neat. It's it looks sort of like a deer or a camel, and it walks around carrying heavy loads for us. But it's sort of hard to describe. How about we just show you and the kids the video?
Oh, that'd be great. Let's watch it.
Let's do it.
Big Dog is a dynamically stable quadruped robot created in 2005 by Boston Dynamics. It was created along with other companies and organizations, including NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. Big Dog is funded by the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency in the hopes that it will be able to serve as a robotic pack mule to accompany soldiers in terrain too rough for regular vehicles to cross. Instead of wheels or treads, Big Dog uses four legs for movement, allowing it to move across surfaces that would defeat wheels. The legs contain a wide variety of sensors, including position and ground contact sensors. He also has two cameras on the front of him that serves as his eyes. Big Dog is 3 feet long, stands 2.5 feet tall, and weighs an amazing 240 pounds, so it's about the size of a small mule. It is capable of walking over very difficult terrain at 4 miles per hour, carrying 340 pounds on its back, and climb up a very steep incline while it's doing this. Pretty incredible. Locomotion is controlled by an onboard computer that receives input from the robot's various sensors. Navigation and balance are also managed by this control system. As you can see, Big Dog is very stable. You can kick him and he'll be able to stay on his feet no matter what. Big Dog can also stay standing on ice. Even though he slips around a lot, he is able to recover and keep himself and the bags on his back off of the ground.
Hello and welcome back. I hope you enjoyed the clip of Big Dog. He's an amazing robot that can carry enormous loads, withstand strong blows, and still not fall over. However, here at NASA, we're not just concerned with the robots that we can build for Earth, but also what we can do in space.
You're absolutely right, Grant. In fact, humans are very interested in exploring Mars. We can't go there ourselves, so we came up with an excellent idea that we're going to send robots there first. And we did a few years ago, and they have been exploring the Martian surface ever since. In fact, let's take a look at what they're doing today.
So first, how are we going to be able to get our robots to Mars? We can't simply get in the car and drive them ourselves. Instead, we need a special spaceships to carry them. First, we need a giant rocket to launch the robot out of Earth's gravity. We need this giant rocket in order to escape Earth's gravity, the very same force that keeps humans stuck to the surface. As you can see, there are many layers of rockets in this spaceship. When we use up all the fuel of one rocket, we simply get rid of a layer of our ship, because underneath is another smaller rocket to keep our spaceship going. Finally, when the spaceship has fired its rockets long enough to escape the influence of our planet, it can set a course to any destination in space. It will now begin the very extensive journey to Mars.